Hello everyone, this is Tuhin Banik from Thatware, and today we'll be discussing about robot.txt. What is it, how to use that for a particular website, and what is the main purpose for robot.txt for websites SEO owners, and also how to make the best utilization of robot.txt for a particular website. So without further ado, let us dive in and discuss more about this topic. So first of all, robot.txt is a text file which is used by the webmasters for instructing Google crawlers and Google bots such as spiders for instructing on the conditions for crawling and indexing of a particular website. For instance, by the help of robot.txt, like one can instruct the crawlers like how to crawl a particular website, which pages to crawl, which pages not to crawl, and there are many more other areas which can be instructed with the help of robot.txt. Some of the common scenarios is like robot.txt can be used to block a particular page, and this can also be used to highlight a particular page if a certain page have an importance in indexing or de-indexing or even crawling. So a proper allow and a disallow function can be used in robot.txt, which we'll be discussing more in this video. So the basic syntax of robot.txt is an user agent. Basically, a user agent is the definition of the crawler. This can be Google bot, this can be Bing bot, this can be any of the bots which can be identified as a web crawler. So user agent is all about defining the bots on which a website should crawl or not crawl. The second protocol is allow function, which starts by allow colon slash. Now allow is to allow a particular URL which needs to be crawled by the spiders or by the web crawlers so that they can be indexed. The third syntax is disallow colon slash, which once again is the vice versa of allow operator, which means that with the help of disallow, a specific URL cannot be indexed or crawled on a given website because they have been instructed for not to index and not to crawl. Then we have crawl delay. Using the crawl delay, it would indicate the web crawler on how much time delay they need to take for doing a crawling on multiple URLs. For instance, if you have one URL and you put a crawl delay of 10, it means that between multiple URL crawling, it will cause a 10 millisecond delay between every single crawling. And this really helps a lot in saving the server bandwidth, which might cause your website to become slow or have any erroneous report. The last operator is sitemap, and this is simply one can define the XML sitemap under the robots, and this would give the web crawlers to identify all the URLs and the locations on a particular website. So that helps in proper crawling and also helps in proper rendering as well. So this is the main syntax of robot.txt, which can help any website owners to instruct the crawlers on how to crawl a particular site and how to index a particular site. And this is very important because this is the main starting point of any online SEO journey, which can really make a lot of difference in the long run. Lastly, few quick SEO tips. First of all, robot.txt should be publicly available. It should not be hidden because crawlers really want to find that, and for that, website name slash robots.txt, this should be the protocol which should be identified. The second thing is it is case sensitive, so it should be used robots.txt only. No error or typos should be there. The third thing is robot.txt should be in public HTML or root folder so that crawlers can easily navigate to the root folder or the public HTML. And the last but not the least, robot.txt should not be having confusing syntax other than the syntax which you have discussed, because if that is the case, then there might be some errors which can pop up on the robot.txt. So this is all about robot.txt. I hope you have gained a short knowledge on how to do that and what are the functions. Lastly, one point to add, if anyone is using WordPress, then this can be also modified from the Yoast SEO plugin or any of the other plugins also. But if the CMS is not WordPress, then this can be directly edited from the public HTML version of the cPanel or the FTP. So this is how the robot.txt file can also be updated or edited or even modified. So thanks for watching this, and I hope this robot.txt file would be helpful for SEOs to make themselves better aware of how to use the robot.txt in the future cases. Thank you.